Welcome to Strider Trees. Today I'm talking about accessing the tree using a moving rope system or a double rope system, DDRT, DRT, the MRS, all of those little acronyms mean the same thing. This is a little excerpt from a Climbing 101 course that's going to be available on my website that should teach you all the basics to get up into a tree for the first time. So hopefully you'll find it valuable. Check it out. So now the rope is set, and we're gonna try and get into the tree. So the next thing we need to do is attach our climb system to our climb rope. Now, I've already done up what's gonna be my climb lanyard here, and I wanna point out a couple of things. So this rope has a spliced eye on the end, and so I can attach a carabiner really easily to this, no knots required. However, my lanyard here, which is essentially just a redundant system, it's the same system that I'm gonna be climbing on, but it's shorter. I've got a little shorter extra rope, and this is so that I can have two tie-in points when I want to switch between them to move within the canopy. This system I've got is two locking carabiners. These are triple locking, so you don't want to just use regular open-close carabiners. They can pop open too easily. They're not safe. And you really don't want to use the climbing carabiners either, like this one here. So a lot of rock climbers have these. They're called screw gate carabiners, where they lock off with a screw. Those aren't particularly safe either, because as often as you're going to be opening and closing these, it's easy to forget to screw the gate locked. And if you do, that's a dangerous thing, because an unlocked screw gate carabiner is just as risky as any other inexpensive non-locking carabiner. So I don't recommend these at all. They're not particularly safe. I like these spring-loaded locking carabiners. They don't open. They lock automatically super easily. Now this rope, like I said, doesn't have a splice on it, so what I tied is called a fisherman's termination knot. I think other people have called it a scaffold knot. And let me show you how to tie that real quick here. It's easy, it's a good termination knot for climbing on. Take your rope, goes through the carabiner, wraps around itself, and then as it comes back around, instead of wrapping down, you wrap up. Up over the top of itself so that it crosses over. And then after it comes around that second time, you're gonna pass it down through the middle of your two wraps. Pass the tail down through the middle of the two wraps. And you'll make sure you leave yourself a little bit of tail. So what we should see is two parallel strands going all the way around the knot, and then a little cross here at the one on the one side. And that knot will cinch down as you put weight on it around your carabiner, and it will tend to lock the carabiner in orientation, which is good. It's a little safer, a little easier to work with like that. So if you don't have an eye, this is a good alternative. As far as setting up your climb system, you want to have your eye on one side, and you want to have your friction hitch on the other. So like I demonstrated before at the tree, this is really all you need for a friction setup. But I'm going to integrate a pulley. It's called a hitch climber or a hitch tending pulley to make it a little bit easier for me to use. Once again, it's not totally necessary, but it certainly makes life a lot easier. You put your pulley down below. I like to put one end of the prusset cord on there just for the sake of keeping track of it. And the knot I'm going to tie here is a friction hitch called a McCoacon. There's a lot of different friction hitches. There's a Valdetain Tress, there's a distal. It's important that you learn one or two of them. I recommend the distal and the McCoacon. Those are my two favorites. But this is what I'm gonna tie here. Go one, two, three, four wraps up. And I might actually end up doing three wraps up because I'm a little bit of a smaller guy. Make sure it crosses over the bottom here, still wrapping, and then I'm gonna reverse the direction of my last wrap on the bottom. Go behind the rope and bring it up underneath that last one. Or the bottom coil, and then back around the front. I might have to add one more wrap in here because it didn't come out real even. Yeah, so that's still slipping. I need to add another wrap. I'll do. Show that one more time here. Got one, two, three, let's go four wraps over, four wraps up, cross over, around the back, and then up through through that bottom one and back down. Once again, this is the McCoacon hitch. It works well. It's important to have a couple different in your back pocket because different ropes interact very differently. But you should be able to pull on it and have it lock, and then you should be able to release it by pulling on the top of the knot. That looks like it's gonna work beautifully. I'll complete that by closing the system there. And then that system I will clip to myself. Now, the reason I use this pulley is for that motion I just demonstrated there. If I didn't have this pulley here, I have to manually advance this hitch with my hand. I have to slide it up. But if I've got this pulley, it slides the knot up for me as I pull on the slack. So if I'm sitting here and I go down and it locks. And when I want to go up, I pull down here and I slide the tail up and it keeps all the slack out of the system. Just like that. And that is your primary climb system. Like I said, I've got some redundancy. I've got a secondary climb system or a positioning lanyard here that'll serve me up in the tree so I can switch between points. But this is gonna be my access. This is my lanyard. They function essentially the same. Just gives me some redundancy. Now, I will be making my way up the tree. I wanna show you guys kind of a basic hip thrust method is what we call it for accessing to the tie-in point. Sorry to interrupt, but if you enjoy my content in this channel and you're looking at diving deeper into tree work, check out stridertrees.com. I've got a course for the beginner who's just looking at getting into the trees for the first time. And I've also got a series that's more tilted towards folks who are already doing residential tree work. It's going to have the safety trainings and the skill trainings starting at new hire to take someone right off the street, make them an apprentice, teach them the more advanced skills all the way to a foreman. And if that's something you'd be interested in, you can leave your email address there on the website and I'll let you guys know first thing when that's available. Also, you can schedule to have me come out to your job site and be a contract climber and an instructor and combine that time to offer you the best value to upgrade your skills with your crew on your job. So you can do that. You can schedule that on my website as well, stridertrees.com. Now, back to the goods. So what I'm looking for is my path up the tree. I like to walk up the leaning side of the tree because it allows me to keep my feet on the back side of it. And it makes it a lot easier. I can help myself up with my legs and I'm not using my arms quite so much. So I'm gonna pass my ropes up and over and around these little branches down here at the base because they're gonna be in my way otherwise. There we go. Now I can just walk right up the back side of this while tending my slack on my climb system. So, like I said, we call this the hip thrust method because what you do is you get your feet up, get your legs up, and then you pull down and hip thrust. Pull down, hip thrust. Now I've got quite a bit of slack in this system, so I gotta tend the slack out, and now I'm safe from fallback. And I'm gonna repeat the maneuver. Hip thrust, oop, and I'm kinda wandering around the trunk a little bit. Take the slack out. And I can use this to work my way right up the tree. As you get more comfortable, you'll probably tend your slack a little bit less frequently because it's easy enough to tend it once you pull your arm with a few strokes, 3 or 4 or 5 strokes, whatever, tend the slack, tend the slack. So that at all points, I'm secure from fall. I might take a swing, I might fall off the side of this, swing out, but I should be safe. Makes for an exciting day when you get a good swing. I keep going up here, and take the slack out. All right, now I'm coming to my first little obstacle. I gotta get around this without swinging off. So this is where my positioning lanyard comes in real handy. If I throw my positioning lanyard here, a little bit of slack around this trunk and connect it back to myself, now I can't swing. So I can keep climbing And that lanyard is going to keep me from swinging around the tree. Going to work my way through some of these branches. And I'm going to keep going around. Now, before I get out of view, she's showing me. Here I go. I'm going to move my rope up this a little bit more. And keep going up. Now that I'm here, disconnect my positioning lanyard, and I can stand right here in this union, tend my slack. Gonna toss down a couple little dead branches that are gonna be in the way. And I've accessed the tree. Once I'm up in the tree, the way I am now, is where I start using the leapfrog trick with my climb systems. So this climb system's gonna terminate right there, and I wanna go higher than that. So what I can do is I put my secondary climb system around a branch, like so, reconnect that to myself, so now I'm connected redundantly. I can actually take off this climb system, pull it back, pass it around a different branch. I could go up this way. I could work my way out this branch if I wanted to, but more likely, we're just gonna go up. So I'm gonna put that right there, reconnect, take out the slack, and start moving up the tree. Take out the slack. So right now I'm at the level of my tying point, so I need to throw my other lanyard around something higher. Let's go around this way. And now I'm connected with my other lanyard. I can leapfrog. I got my climb line again. And pull a little bit of slack. Throw it up and over a branch, right there. Now I've got that back to me. I can connect it back up again. Take up the slack. And away we go. Onwards and upwards. You get the idea. Now you're tree climbing. Beautiful.